Hi guys, this is gsnl.com and I'm here with the Motorola One Vision. So we had it for a few days of testing ahead of its launch. Now the phone has become official, so we can tell you everything about it. This is an unboxing and a short pre-review of the handset. So let's see what's inside the box. We're dealing here with a special phone. It's called Motorola One Vision, and the whole Vision thing is all about the camera and the special screen. Now, if you remember, the folks of Sony have inaugurated the 21:9 aspect. This phone from Motorola also adopts a similar aspect. Long, it's supposed to offer a sort of wider angle of viewing, which is fit for a cinematic experience. We have the blue version of the phone, and the price tag should be around $350 to $400. So, unveiled in Brazil on May 15th, as fresh as it gets, dual camera at the back, and I'm going to start off with the interior of the box, putting the phone aside for now. So we got a flexible and transparent case inside the box, and then a bunch of manuals with useful info, Motorola One Vision. Of course, the metal key used to access the slots, and a pretty hefty charger, which promises turbo power fast charging. Okay, putting it back here, and then surprise, surprise, a pair of headphones, but not the average ones. They're actually branded Motorola and seem a bit more premium than usual, as you can see for yourself. Also slightly sloped, so they will go into the ear better. And last but never least, there is the USB Type-C to full USB cable, which we have here. Okay, so that's that. That's the content of the box. Everything you were expecting is here, plus the case. And now it's time to focus on the device itself. Let me fire it up. It's actually a bit of a premiere for Motorola. It's the first Motorola phone with selfie camera cutout in the screen. It's part of the Android One initiative, so it's going to get the updates pretty fast to Android Q and Android R. The screen has a 21:9 aspect ratio, and it comes in the sapphire gradient, which we have here, and it's quite pretty, and also a special bronze gradient, which is basically brown with a twist. The thickness is 8.7 millimeters, and the device weighs 180 grams. What you're seeing here is a 6.3 inch screen, and yes, I know I'm not setting up the phone right now. I've already played with it for a few days, just to make sure that I'm delivering a proper set of impressions for you. So as I was saying, 6.3 inches LTPS IPS LCD and the resolution of 2520 over 1080 pixels. Inside there is an interesting processor. I'm talking about the Exynos 9609. It's actually a relative of the Exynos 9610, which you found on the Samsung Galaxy A50, which we're still testing. So they borrowed that CPU from Samsung in a tweaked version, and we also get 4 GB of RAM, 128 GB of storage, plus micro SD card slot. Other than that, there's a 3500 mAh battery here, and also 15 watt turbo power charging. We're running on Android 9.0 Pie in a pretty clean and stock experience. We also have Dolby Smart Audio. There's IP52 water protection, not very waterproofing, but you get it. And we have glass at the back, glass at the front, and they're calling it 4D glass this time. There's FM radio, there's an audio jack at the top, there's an USB Type-C port at the bottom, and a speaker next to it. Let's see what else. The fingerprint scanner is placed at the back side, below the main camera. It's in this dimple with the Motorola logo. Of course, 4G LTE is part of the package, and I feel it's time to talk about the other reason for the name, One Vision. So, vision number one has to do with the screen, and I want to show you how immersive it can get when you're watching a video. Okay, and let's go here, access our channel, GSM Dome. Here we go. Let's say we're watching the Motorola Moto G7 Power review. Okay, this is an ad. Skip, and here we go. Okay, now we're going full screen. Okay, and we're zooming in, and voila! That's how we're going to watch the videos on this 21:9 aspect display. That's what Motorola wanted for you. I know the cutout is a bit on the big side, but it's supposed to not bother you if you've gotten accustomed to the format. So basically, it's just Sony and Motorola trying this out right now. Now, I promised you that I'm going to talk about the camera. So this one here is a combo of 48 megapixels and 5 megapixels. The main camera is the 48 megapixel one with optical image stabilization and f1.7 aperture, and also it has a quad pixel technology, so it will not deliver 48 megapixel shots but rather 12 megapixel shots with bigger pixels and a lot of details. Dual LED, dual tone flash, and 4K video capture plus a special night mode which you won't find on many mid-rangers. At the front side, 25 megapixel shooter, the selfie camera, which is embedded with a cutout straight into the display, with its own flavor and taste of the quad pixel technology. We obviously have, what am I talking about? Let's show you. We obviously have a portrait mode, and let's see here, we got portrait, we got cutout, spot color, night vision, cinemagraph, panorama, live filter, slow motion, and this is actually the first time I'm seeing a slow motion filming option for the front camera. Here we go. I have to admit, I haven't seen this before, slow motion filming for the selfie camera. Other options, you can also use the RAW format, leveler, assist, smart composition, shot optimization is also part of the package, so AI should also help you at some point. Okay, and of course you can do filming, as I said before, in 4K with stabilization on your side, you can activate it from here. Other things worth mentioning, well, you have selfie cutouts, and well, Android One keeps things in check. I actually took some photos with the camera, I've already tested it. This is not the full review, so I'm going to be back with extra details, but in the meantime, you can have a look. Okay, so the best aspects about the phone is the fact that you can mess around with the selfies, so you can take the full 25 megapixel selfie with a ton of details, as you can see, or you can use quad pixel technology and only take the smaller selfies, which are easier to post online, but still pretty good details, nice face setup, and this has got to be one of the best selfie cameras I've ever seen on a Motorola phone and on a mid-range phone. Here you can apply some effects, black and white background and studio lighting and all that. And those are only some examples. Many more to be found in the full review. The colors are pretty vivid. I would say the experience is on par with the Motorola Moto G7 Plus, if not a bit better. We have some close-ups of roses, which are pretty great. And we also tested the stabilization, but you're going to find out more about that in the review. Quick checkup here, just to show you the portrait features. So, this is a new approach. Instead of having a slider, you have levels for your blur. You start at blur 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you get the idea. And then there are the studio effects, there's the studio, there's the side, sunshine, stage, basically the ones you've seen on Huawei and the iPhones for a while now. So I guess this has been a sort of smaller review or a preview for the phone, basically an alternative that's more cinematic and more, I would say, camera focused than the Motorola Moto G7 Plus. A drawback is the lack of stereo speakers, I would say, maybe also waterproofing, but the design is truly beautiful. So Motorola went into two areas, the gradient and the selfie camera cutout. And of course, the cinematic approach, which is a bit risky, but it may pay off. I find the bezels to be a bit thick, but in the end, not a bad experience. It's a narrow phone, easy to grip, comfy in the hand, and I would say that it takes pictures somewhere around the high mid-ranger and almost, I would say, last year flagship. This has been the first contact and first impressions and a sort of pre-review of the Motorola One Vision here at gsmdom.com. And just to remind you, here we go, we're going to access gsmdom.com. And by the way, courtesy of this elongated format, you can fit more content onto the scrollable screen. So that's it, folks. This has been the pre-review of the Motorola One Vision at gsmdom.com. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll be back with a full review very soon and a lot of photo samples. Bye-bye.